This conference will now be recorded.
Hi guys, we from Data Platform Trainings provide training on different technologies like Microsoft SQL Server, Microsoft Azure SQL, Microsoft Power BI, Microsoft Business Intelligence. Please subscribe my channel, Data Platform Trainings on YouTube channel. And in case of any queries related to this, one of this technology or any of the technology, related to the SQL Server, Azure SQL, or Power BI, or Business Intelligence, SSIS, SSRS, and ES, please write email us at the rate at Azure SQL training at the rate gmail.com. We'll get back to you with the proper solution for your query. Okay, let's go into the today's topic. Today, I would like to talk about Azure Data Lake and Azure Active Directory and Azure SQL Data Warehouse and Azure SQL Data Warehouse with PolyBase feature. How we are going to load the data from Azure Data Lake store to Azure SQL Data Warehouse using PolyBase mechanism. I hope you already went through the video which I have recorded about Azure Data Lake Store, which I have kept in the YouTube channel, in my channel. And Azure Data Lake Store is nothing but it's a high enterprise storage repository to store a file of any size, and it can be any type, or it can be a multiple files or a single file where it can be stored in a single place for analytics purpose. The data, it is built on the top of Azure storage. It is mainly for the purpose of analytic purpose only, where you have data, you process the, where the files are kept in single location, Azure Data Lake Store, you process the data and put the output in single location, that is Azure Data Lake Store or Azure Data Storage Generation 1 or Azure Data Storage Generation 2. These are one and the same, but they are renaming from version to version, and data is placed, put in this location, and it is processed, and output is stored in single location, and this is being used for analytic purpose, and it is used mainly for operational and exploratory analytics. This is what is Azure Data Lake Store. Let's go back now. We'll talk about Azure Active Directory. Okay, when you are putting data into Azure Data Lake Store, there should be some authentication for the developers to authenticate or to store the data into Data Lake Store. That authentication for read write access is provided using Azure Active Directory authentication library. And it enables users to authenticate users to cloud or on-premise Active Directory and obtain tech token for securing API calls. And you can configure that to access the stores. And the token expires. You can refresh that token to get new token key. And simultaneously, you can make asynchronous methods called to access Azure Data Lake Store. The next one, we'll talk about, we'll create Azure SQL Data Warehouse. And you might have seen Azure SQL Database also, but when you go for Azure Data Warehouse, SQL Data Warehouse, it's nothing but a enterprise data warehouse, which is mainly for MPP purpose. This is called massively parallel processing to run a complex queries of petabytes of data that is stored in data warehouse, and using SQL T-SQL commands, using this power of MPP, you run these queries for high performance for analytic purpose, and you can analyze the data and you can put in single place and you can analyze and use for operational purpose. Okay, this is what SQL Data Warehouse. I'll show you how to create SQL Data Warehouse also. Let's go to the next slide. And after we create Azure Data Lake Store, and after I give authentication using Azure Active Directory to Azure Data Lake Store, after that I'll create Azure SQL Data Warehouse, and after that I'll try to read the files kept in Azure Data Lake Store with Azure SQL Data Warehouse PolyBase feature, and there we'll try to create master key, storage credential, external data, external file format, external table. Okay, let's go and jump into the demo session. Let me log into the portal. Let me open this Google portal.azure.com is a site where for login for Microsoft Cloud. It takes 1-2 minutes to get loaded. Okay, once you log in, you'll get this dashboard. You can see all the resources that are created till now. Okay, now the first one, I'll create Azure Data Lake Store. Just go click here, go to storage, Data Lake Store, Azure Data Lake Store generation one. Click here, demo. I'll give some name here for Azure Data Lake Store generation one. Demo Azure Data Lake storage. Okay, the name is verified, it's available, and a free trial subscription is free because we are using free trial subscription provided by Microsoft. And next is resource group is nothing but logical container of resource. I'm using the resource group as RG test. You can use any, you can create by yourself also. If you don't have, you can create by clicking create and give the name. You can give the name it creates if you don't have resource group. I already have. Let's go and use it, the existing one. And the location is, you can see these are the only location which Azure Data Lake Storage Generation supports. Locations are nothing but data centers here. I'm taking East Central US, and price packages pay as you go is nothing but they don't charge money for storage, but they charge money for processing the files. And here the data lake storage generation one or the data lake store or data lake storage generation two, the size is unlimited. They don't charge price for storage, they charge only for processing the files. Okay, and it is nothing but pay as you go. Okay, once you use, you need to pay the price, otherwise they don't charge you. And encryption settings, it's nothing but whenever you are trying to load the data into Data Lake Store, once the data is getting loaded into your Data Lake storage, it will encrypt the data and save in that location. And at the same time, when user is trying to access the data, the same thing happens again. It will decrypt the data and show to the user to read, so that he will be able to read the data. That is the mechanism what encryption and decryption settings are set on the cloud. Let's click on create here. Now the data lake storage generation is going to get created. Now you should be able to see here the deployment in progress. Okay, once it is gets created, then we'll create a folder. Let's see step by step. It takes hardly 1 or 2 minutes of time to get created, nothing but provisioning the resource in the cloud or deploying the resource in the cloud or creating a resource in the cloud. Now we are creating Azure Data Lake Store generation one, and you can see here deployment to the resource group RG test. Okay, it's nothing but it's these all resources that we are creating will be placed in this resource group. Okay, yeah, let's see, let's wait till it get deployed. it got deployed. Now you can see deployment is success and it deployed to some resource group. Click on pin to dashboard. Okay, pin to dashboard. Now just see the resource that you have created should be deployed, right? We have created with name Azure Data Lake Storage storage. Let's see. See here, you can able to see here. Demo Azure Data Lake Store storage. Click on this. Okay. Once you click there, okay, you will be navigated. You can see the price as you pay as you go. Click on the Explorer. Click here. There are no folders created. Now try to click here, create a folder. I'll create a folder with data files here. Say okay. Okay, now I created a folder but no files. I'll try to upload the files, but the files are not loaded like this. We need to use a mechanism called Azure Data Factory. We'll talk later in coming sessions. Click on upload here. Click on folder, right? Just go to, I'll just try to upload the files here. Okay, click on open and click on allow override existing files, add files here. Okay, now you can see the files has got loaded, right? Complete status completed. Now you can see again. Let's take some time to get refresh. Don't worry. We'll just refresh here. Now you should be able to see. Now what? You are getting these three files created. Right? Three files has got created now. What we should do here is, we have created. Now we should give access to this folder, right? We should give access to, either you should give the access to this folder, or you can give access to this data files folder or to the root folder. That is demo Azure data lake storage. You can give anything. Let's go to the access. Click here access. Okay, once you click here, then you should able to see this. There are no access permissions assigned here, right? To us give that access permissions, we should go and create Azure Active Directory to give the permissions, right? Let's go back now. I'll just close this. I'll create Azure Active Directory. Then through that, I'll try to give the access. How to create Azure Active Directory? Go to the favorites here. Okay, go to favorites. Click on Azure Active Directory here. Okay, and once you get to this default directory, there is something called app registration. Click on app registration here. Okay. Now let's go and create a new app. Click on new application. Otherwise you'll already have, but will not use any app created. We'll create a new app here. Just click new app application registration. Okay. Give some name of the application, name of the Azure Active Directory or name of application also. Give demo Azure Active Directory. Okay. And this is got verified. Now go here. Now in this application type, you have negative and web app or API. No, go for web app or API. Now you have single URL. Give some valid URL. Whether that URL is present on the internet or not doesn't matter, but you should give an valid URL, www.somename.somedomain.com, right? I'll give www.somexyz.com also. This you will not find in the internet. And when you get out of this box, it is giving error. What does it is saying is URL must be a valid URL format, means it should start with http://, or https://, and it should be size of 255 characters, right? Let's go. I'll give https://. Now you see that has got verified. Now click create here. Now the app is getting created, right? App has got successfully created. Now you should be able to see the home page of this, and the app is got registered with the name called Demo Azure Active Directory. Just copy this app name. Okay, I'll say why we require. I'll just try to open the notepad here, because we all these things should be handy in your the application name Azure Active Directory. Active Directory. Okay, app name is this. What is that app name? Just copy this here. Okay, I'll just place it here. App name. Now when you go to this window, you'll find this. You are able to see this application ID, right? Just have this handy, because this application ID are required for PolyBase when you're trying to access the Azure data lake store. Okay, just have this application ID handy here. Just copy this app ID. Okay, right. Now go to the same one, click on settings here. You have taken application ID, click on settings. Here there is something keys here. You need to generate a access keys. Okay, click on, then you will open a window called keys window blade. Give a key underscore value. Duration is never expires. Click on save. Okay, copy this value and keep it handy. Why means, you see here, copy the value. You won't be able to retrieve after you leave this blade. Copy this value here. Okay, key here. App key. Okay, now you are able to see that this app key, right? Because you should keep it handy, because once you close, you'll not able to retrieve. Just close this. Okay, close this window also. Now you are in default directory. Now what name you have created with this same name, right? You have created with this name. Now you should get, you should have auth token 2.0 token endpoint also you required now. You require, right? How do you get is, just go to that here. Okay, come there. Now select that directory, the app that you have created, Azure Active Directory app registration. Just close this. Once you have selected, you will be able to just close this. Now you have selected. Go to this endpoints. Click on this endpoints here. Now you should be able to see this auth 2.0 token endpoint. Just copy this one token, copy this and paste it here. Okay, now you have app name, application ID, application key, and token, that is token endpoints also you have handy. Let's go enough. Now we should give, what we should do, we have created Azure Data Lake Store and we have created Azure Active Directory. Now we should give the permission to Azure Data Lake Store using this app name, right? And how we are going to do that, let's see. Let's come on. I'll just close this. Let's go. Click on that Azure Data Lake Store that we have created, right? This is the name that we have created, right? Just go here. Okay, this is what, go to Data Explorer. This is the files that we have done. You should be able to see. Now go to, I'm selecting the parent one, root folder. Go to Access, click on Access button here. Once you click Access, you'll be navigated to Access Blade. Okay, then you have click on Add button here. Select the user or group. Okay, and take the, now you should get the name, you should search by the name of the app that you have created in Azure Active Directory. Okay, the name is Demo Azure Active Directory, right? If you know, you can type, otherwise you can just type demo and search for that. Just go, we have created Azure Active Directory as demo, right? Azure Active Directory, demo Azure Active Directory. Just click here, select. This is the name that we have created, right? Azure Demo Azure Active Directory. Just go there. Now give the permission, read, write, execute. This folder because parent folder and sub child folders in that parent folder, then this folder and all the children folder, and access entry and default entry permission entry, click OK. Okay, now see here, all the access have been set, and here the Active Directory that you have created is assigned. Means for that, now you have a read, write, execute permissions on Azure Data Lake Store. If you don't set this, you will not able to read that data from Azure Data Lake Store. Okay, you should have this app Azure Active Directory app registered and giving access to this Azure Data Lake Store, and that should be assigned with the permission, right? Just say close it now. Right now, what we have done, we have created Azure Data Lake Store and Azure Active Directory, and we have given the permission also. Let's go back now. The next step is we need to create SQL, Azure SQL Data Warehouse, right? Just click on create here, databases. Click on, once you create a resource, click on databases. Click on SQL Data Warehouse. Okay. Once you click, it will ask for the some of the details here. Let's go and give databases demo. Okay. And for subscription is free trial, and resource group, I already told you, we are taking RG test and blank. What do you want? Any sample database here? I want to go with a blank, and he's asking for the server. Database alone will not solve our purpose. We should have a server. In that server, we should have a database. So now you should configure the server. Click on this configure server. Now see here, it is asking for the name of the server. Just go demo DWS server. Right? Give the administrator login, admin name. I'll give demo user as the name of the admin, and he's asking the password to rules, follow some of the rules, just read them. Okay, give the confirm password also, and the location is this. These are the locations which Azure database SQL database is supporting. Let's go with South India. Just select here. Okay, now it is asking for the performance level. Click on this storage generation 1 and storage generation 2. I'll just take the storage generation 1 only. In data SQL data warehouse also, we have generations 1 and 2. Okay, and I'll take generation 1 only. And there are, you can see here, there is something called DWU. It's nothing but data warehouse units. Okay, it's, you can see here, now it's on DW 400 units. Nothing but 400 DW units, DW data warehouse units. And this is for perform to increase your performance of your SQL data warehouse. Okay, I'll take, if you can move that, now it is 300. If you move 200, if you move your 100, based on that, the price also vary. Now it is 100, you can see 111 rupees. If you go for 200, 223. If you go for 300, you 335 per hour. And this is DWU is only for the increase the performance of your SQL data warehouse. Let's go and keep it for 100. Apply here. Okay. We are going with the generation 1, not with the generation 2. Click on create. The SQL data warehouse is getting created. Okay, it is getting submitted, nothing but deploying or provisioning, or you can say that it is deploying or provisioning or creating the resource, right? You can say that. When it is good, get success, it will show you the deployment is successful. Just hold on for 2 to 3 minutes. It is still getting deployed. It takes time because it takes it is going to create a resource and deploy the operating system. It takes all the time. Still getting deployed. Just wait a minute. You can see still running this. Let me refresh this. It's taking time. If that has got created, then we can do it. Okay. Let's see. We have created a SQL Server data warehouse, right? Yeah, we'll search by name here. We'll just try to refresh, okay? We'll try to refresh and see. This should get created. We are not pinned to dashboard, so it's not, we are not pinned to dashboard, so it's not giving, showing you. Just refresh this. Yeah, you should able to see now the server is here. Right, demo DA, click on this, right? Server, you have a server here. Now how do you access the server? Now how do you access server is just what you need to do: open your local management studio, the installed on your local machine, that is desktop or laptop. Go here, click on management studio locally. I'm opening on the local because I need to connect to that server which is in cloud. So using management studio, I'll be able to connect to that server. Okay, because this is a PaaS service that we are using it. Let the SQL Server get it open. Okay, now the SQL Server management studio is open now. You can see there is no connection here. So to access this server, the server that we have created, right? Let's open this once again. Click on that server. Okay, click on that. You can see here, once you click on the server or database also, you can go to the database where you can see this, all the database present in you. Click on this. Okay, there are no database present. I think I have selected the wrong one. Let's go and see. Or should we create one more? Let's see now. Okay, don't worry. Or we can go and create in our management studio also. Yeah, just a minute. Yeah, I think it didn't get created. Let's go and create now. Let's check for this. I'm checking for the demo database. Yeah, let's see. Otherwise, we'll try to go and create one more. Click on resource, create database here. We'll do it in 2 minutes of time. Yeah, it's already there, but I don't know why it's not available. We already created demo. Okay, I'm giving the name. It's already there. Name already exists. Let's see now. See, it's already there. Name. Okay, demo server. Let's select in the year. Okay, this is the what we have created. Let's go here. See, the demo database is already there. We have created SQL server the which we have created earlier. Now once you click on database, okay, there's a demo database here, and you can see the server name. Okay, click on the server here. You'll come to this page. Now to connect to that machine, from your local machine, you need to connect to the server which is in the cloud. So what you need to do, go to this firewall settings, click on the firewall settings here, and you need to add your local IP address. Okay, you need not do anything. Just click on add client IP here. Now you should be able to see this address added. Just save now. Click on save. Okay, just click on save. It got saved. Now take this server URL. Okay, copy this. Okay, open your management studio that is on the local, right? Click on connect here in the Object Explorer. Click here. Now give the name here. Use name of the server. Authenticate is SQL. Give the username. I'm using demo user only. Administrator as a password. Okay, now I clicked. Now you should be able to see the database here, demo database that we have created. In the tables you see here, click on tables, external table you have, and here you have external data sources and external files. Why this external table is required is when you want to read the data outside the table, means outside other than table, because in the table you already have a data inserted or populated, right? Other than the table, if data is in Azure storage or data in Azure data lake store, if the data is in Hadoop, then you should go for external table, right? Let's take a new query here. To do that, what should we do is just we'll open the PPT. First you need to create a master key. Without master key you'll not able to work on PolyBase. What is master key is? It's nothing but a key that is getting generated with full credentials. And you should have a single master key per database, not more than one master key. If you have created master key now, if anyone else is also trying to create a master key, then already existing master key should be deleted and new should be created. But you can't create more than one master key in the database. Let's go and create the master key. Let's see with the step by step. We should do the four steps here. Sorry, five steps. Five steps are nothing but you can see here. First, master key. Right? Next, after that is over, we need to create scoped storage credential. After that is over, we need to create external data source. After that is over, we need to create external file format, then external table. Right? Let's go step by step. First, we'll create a master key. Create master key encryption. Okay, follow by password. This is the syntax that I have given. Now, should you should give the password here. Give any password. I'll give Azure @12345. Okay, just run. Now you are created. To check the where the master keys are there, what you need to do is just select here, select start from. You have some systems tables where there it is stored. sys.symmetric. Okay, _keys. Just run this. You should able to see the master key that is created. Okay, master key that is created with the password. Okay, yeah, let's go to the new query. After master key is over, then we should create a scoped credential, right? Let's go create a scoped credential, right? Let's go. The syntax for this is create. I'll write syntax, then I'll try to put values, appropriate values there. Okay, create database scoped credential. Name of the scope credential. Okay, with identity. Okay, identity equal to comma, and there's a parameter secret. Then after semicolon, in identity, what should you get is you should get here the application key, that is app ID @. Okay, then you should get auth 2.0 token and endpoint. Sorry, endpoint. This in the year, what should get it? You should give the app key that we have created, right? We already have Handy in the notepad. They should say, let's go. I'll try to replace the value with the appropriate values here. Just go. The name, give some name. I'll give something Azure SQL Data DWH as a scope credential. I'm giving this name. Now app ID should be given here. Let's go to the notepad. You have app ID. Take this and paste here. App ID. Okay. Now you should go here. There is token 2.0, right? Take the token here. This is a token, right? Take this token here and paste it here. Okay. These all should be in single quotes here. Just go put in single quotes. Right now app key, go here in the notepad. We already have Andy. Just take this and put here, and this also you need to put in single quote. Okay, just go there. Now I try to run F5. Okay, now you should able to see this database scope credential. Now you can see, if you want you can check from the system table also, no worries. After this is over, what should we do? We should create data source, right? External data source. Let's go and create external data source, right? Create external data source, because the data is in data lake store. We should provide the location of where the data is stored with that URL. Let's go create external data source. Okay, and name of data source. Okay, with you have parameter something like type here. This is by default Hadoop. This is the default value. Okay, after this is over, then location. Okay, it is nothing but URL of the URL of data lake store or gen 1 or gen 2. Okay, after this is over, credential that we have created earlier. Name of the credential. Okay, let's take this, copy here, give the name here. I give something Azure DWH data source. Any name you can give. I told type is by default is Hadoop. You should not change. Now you should go for the URL. Let's go to the portal. Okay, let's go to the URL of data lake store. Let's go close this. Let's go to the data lake store that we have created. Click on this. Okay, now click on this data explorer. Now you can get the URL of this. Click here. Sorry, click on the folder. Now you are selected on the top. Click on folder properties. You can get the path here. Take this path. Don't go to the child. Don't go to the subfolder or children folder. Take only the parent one. And after you take the parent, click on the folder properties. Once you click on the folder property, you'll get a new window with the properties. Just take this. Okay. Just take. This is the location. Put in single quotes here. Remove this forward slash. Okay. Now try to run this. Okay. Once you run this, it will validate that location, whether the URL is valid or not. There is syntax there. Okay. We have not given the name of the credential, right? Let's go to the other window which we have created the credential. The name is here, Azure SQL DWH credential. Just copy this and paste this here, the name of the credential. Paste it here. Now try to run. Press F5. Now it got created. Now take a new window, new query. Okay. Now take a, we should create a file format, right? Let's go. Create a file format. Right. Let's go. Let's create the file format here. Create external file format. You give some name of the file. Name of file format with semicolon here. You should have some parameters here. Format type. Comma, that should be the format type there, and format options. Okay, you give the file field delimiter. What is a field delimiter? I'll just open and show you. Field terminator. Okay, semicolon, and you should give what is a field terminator in that. Okay, now let's copy this syntax here. This is a syntax. Let's put here. I'll give some name, Azure DWH file format, and the format is delimited. Let's go there. Click here. This is the file that you have. You can see this is a delimited format. It is getting delimited. Every column is getting delimited with comma operator, right? And this is nothing but delimited format. The file format is delimited and the field terminator is comma, right? Just go there. give delimited text, and field term is comma, right? Just go now create. There is some syntax problem there. Let's go. Where is that field terminator? What is that? Comma, invalid syntax. Let's see. File format is correct. Format type is correct. Field terminated. And format options is also correct. And field terminated is this. Is equal to comma. Yeah, it's right. Yes, it's right. Yeah, this is the one which we are added one more. Okay, just try it, because this should not be there, because we are doing it in here, right? They should not be there. Now just run this. Now it got created, right? We have done with this four. Now we should do with external file only, right? Let's go to the data lake. You have four columns, one EMP 1,000, 10 department. We have four fields, right? Let's go create new query here. Create a external table, right? Just go syntax create external table. Table name of the table, right? Give the columns here. You should give the column names. Column 1, data type 1. What is the data type? Column 2, data type 2. Okay. Dot dot. Column n, data type n. Right? This is the structure. Then we should come with width. We should give the parameters here. What parameters? We have created a location, right? What is locate? This is a location. Okay, single quotes, comma, data source. We have given that URL in the data source, right? Give that data source here, and we have created a file format. Okay, just go. Let's go. Data source here. Sorry. I'll close this window. The file format is a create external file format. This is the name of the file format. Give the name here, and we have data source here, right? We have created, just give the data source, nothing but URL, right? Just go here, data source here. Okay, now you should give the location, right? Sorry, I'll just put this empty. I'll take down and write. Let's take this. I'll paste down. Okay. Now give the data source or file format. We have file format. Give name of the file. Just give you a file format name. Go to data source. Give here. And location. Okay. What location is? And before giving location, we'll try to write the column names. EMP ID begin, EMP name varchar 50, EMP sal decimal some 18, 2, four columns we are taking it. EMP department member int we have created, right? If you see this, you should be able to see enough four columns. That four columns we are given here. Now location, we should give the location, right? Let's go back now. We are given the URL, right? This folder, we have given this, and we are taking the URL for data source. But actual files are placed in which folder? This data files, right? This file, this folder, we should give the location. This folder, right? Take this folder, because the files are located in this folder. Just give the location of the folder. Copy this and paste it here. And you should give the forward slash, because in that folder you have a files here, right? If you see, In this folder, you have property files. Just now try to run F5. Okay, this we are not given the name of the table. Let's give ext employee. Press F5 here. We are creating a table. It takes time to verify the location and data source and file format. Later that it is going to get created, right? It got created. Now let's see in here in the Object Explorer. Just refresh. You should be able to see the name of the table. The table which we have created, you can see here. And data source also. Data source, file format. Just see here. Data source, file format here. Now go here. Select. Okay, just select this and press F5. You should be able to see the data of the three files there. Okay, now you are able to see the data, right? Now it got created and you are able to see the data, right? And what happens is when you create an external table, only the schema of the table is present in the table database. Sorry, the schema of nothing but this structure is present. This structure, the file table structure with data type and location, data source and file format is present. But actual data is in data lake store. So here in external table, you will not be able to insert or delete or update the records in the table. You will not able to do. And other thing is you can truncate the table enough. Once you drop the table, drop external table ex employee. If you drop this, only structure is getting deleted from this database, but data will be still in this folder. Okay, data will be there. Let's go and do it. Just select drop external table, table name, click on this. Now it got deleted. Now try to refresh this. See here, there is no table here. Right, there is no table enough. The reason is we have dropped, but you can go to the Azure and see here. Just try to refresh now. Go here, click on more and refresh. Now you are able to see the data. Data is still there. The only schema with external table was created in the database with external table, but data was lying in the data lake store. Now that we have dropped that table, then when you drop, the schema is getting deleted, but the data is still there. And at the same time, you will not be able to insert or delete, update the records from that storage. Okay, this is what I was able to tell you. What we have done, we have created data lake store, then I've given the Azure Active Directory permissions for that, and later we have created a SQL Server Data Warehouse, then we have created the PolyBase. I hope you have enjoyed this video. I request, if you are satisfied with this video, please I request you to subscribe my YouTube channel, that is Data Platform Trainings. And if at all you have any queries, please email us. We'll come with appropriate answer or solution to you. I request you to forward this message to your friends also. Ask them to subscribe the channels for the latest updates on SQL Server, Azure or Power BI or Business Intelligence. Thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you once again. And don't forget, click on like or comment on the video once you view the video. Thank you so much, guys. Thank you so much.